What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. Yeah. Oh, baby, how do you know? All I need is my brother. I say I'm gonna get high.
Welcome to Book Time with Ryan. I am Ryan, and today I'll be talking about Listening for the Crack of Dawn by Donald Davis. I have had this book for 30 years. I was given this book on October 7th, 1992. It's signed to Ryan with my good wishes and hope for your good reading, Donald Davis. I didn't read this until this week. So 30 years I've been sitting on this book, but this book is very important to me. I got this shortly after moving to Tennessee from upstate New York, which was a pretty big change. It was given to me, or it was purchased, I guess, probably, at an event at my school, my new school, and the author was there, the author being Donald Davis. So Donald Davis is a storyteller. And this was, I think this may have been his first book, but I'm not 100% sure about his first book. So the first time he had kind of transitioned from oral storytelling to the written storytelling format. And I believe it happened in 1991, but this one's from 1992. This is the paperback. This is so old that it even has my little library of Ryan White stamp on it, which I don't even do anymore. I still have it, but I don't do it. So why is this book so important to me? I've said this before on the channel, I promise I won't always talk about this, but I have dyslexia, and growing up I didn't read. I wasn't reading when I got this book, but I thought it had a really cool cover, and I was just so excited about Donald Davis. Now, why was I excited about Donald Davis? This. For the Generation Zers watching, this is a cassette tape. And I listened to this tape thousands of times, I would think. This has Dr. York and the Typhoid Shot and Old Man Hawkins Lucky Day. I listen to this all the time, and somehow I still have it. So this is from 1991. Just I loved this. It's actually in the middle of a story too. It's not at the very beginning. I love the stories on this. And I was so excited to have a book from him signed, just because for years, even though I didn't read this, this cassette tape was so important to me. But this week I was looking up on my bookshelf and I just finished reading Ahab's Wife. And I was like, what am I going to do next? What am I going to read? I hadn't planned on anything. And then it was sitting there looking at me and I thought, why not? 30 years in the making. I'm finally going to read this book. I'm pretty sure this is the longest book I've had in my personal possession. That's not a children's book. Now, I didn't know what to expect with this, because the Donald Davis stories that were in this, on this cassette tape, weren't necessarily for kids, but they were safe for kids. And I didn't know if the book was going to be the same way. It's not as safe for kids. There are certainly stories in here that are sad. There are stories in here that are not violent, but gruesome. A kid loses his foot on railroad tracks. He got run over by a train. The kid lived, but the foot was not saved. So what is this? This is Listening for the Crack of Dawn. It is a master storyteller recalls the Appalachia. I should probably say that right. A master storyteller recalls the Appalachia of the 50s and 60s. I don't know how old Donald Davis is now. I sent him an email today. I actually sent him an email 10 years ago to talk about what his work meant to me. And in searching for that email so I could email him today, I found it, and it was from 2012. This book is basically organized into short stories about him, about Donald Davis and his brother, Joe Brother, and his family. It's almost chronological. It may have started out with before they were in kindergarten, at least before they were in first grade, and then it kind of goes through the grades. And it's just Donald Davis talking about stories from growing up. Now, I don't know if these are all true stories. And I spent probably 30 minutes trying to figure out if this is a work of fiction or a work of nonfiction. I don't know. On Amazon, it has it, you know, how Amazon does like the ranking of the book in different genres or different categories. And it was ranked somewhere in biographies, which would be nonfiction to me, but then also ranked in children's fiction. So that doesn't clear anything up for me. The stories in this book are stories that are very believable. They are the stories that your friends tell you that you want to hear. It's a difference between somebody telling a story and having to finish it off with, and then I found $5. And stories where he said, tell me again, tell me that funny story again. You go to a party and you're like, hey, Donald, tell that story about whatever it was. That's how this book is. It's so believable that there are parts where you kind of hope it's going to go somewhere, and then it does. And you're like, that's perfect, because that's what would have naturally happened. And that's why I don't know if it's nonfiction or fiction, because if it's fiction, it's very believable fiction. And if it's inspired by Donald Davis's life growing up, then you can see that. If it's just all made up stories, then he did a really good job at grounding it in reality. I have looked for where this mostly took place, Sulphur Springs, North Carolina, and I can't find it. So in my email to Donald Davis, I actually ask him, where is this? I can't find the county. I can't find the city. And I don't know if those names have changed, because some of this is taking place in the 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. Kind of goes up through the Vietnam War. I don't know if it's a fictional place or if it's a real place and I just can't find it on the map. There's a million Sulphur Springs apparently in the United States. I couldn't find one near Asheville. My grandmother lived in Asheville for a while. Asheville, North Carolina, not Nashville, Tennessee. That's where we lived. So I've been to Asheville. I've been in the Smoky Mountains where I think this takes place. I really want to figure out if this is a real place and where it is and how I can find it so I can actually look at maps of it. And maybe one day we'll drive through there. I don't know. That's kind of what I like to do with books. I like to find where they're located and experience a little bit of that. This is an interesting time for him to cover because there's a transition between, in a lot of parts of Appalachia, the parts of the Appalachian Mountains, transition between very rural life to more modern living with internal plumbing, power, lights. And that's kind of what they're going through. So there are some houses in this that are log cabins that don't have internal plumbing, that don't have running water, that don't have electricity. And, I think even Donald Davis talking about this discusses how they would go to his grandpa and grandmother and found some kind of reassurance in the older ways of their houses, because everywhere else they were confronted with all this modern technology, and it was a lot for kids to figure out. I mean, we're talking Vietnam War, we're talking about at some point the death of Kennedy, we're talking Cuban Missile Crisis, Korean War, post-World War II action. This is an area that is relatively poor in a lot of places. There is some level of racism, some remnants of Native American culture in their area too. So it's a very interesting look. I have not read very many books set in this time about this area, and it's an area that I'm somewhat familiar with. So it was very cool. For me, it was just great to return to Donald Davis, because even though I don't have a tape player, I haven't listened to this tape in years now. My car doesn't have a tape player. I don't know how I would listen to it anymore. I mean, I should just go out and buy a tape player. I could buy it digitally. There are digital copies of this. The stories on this tape are still fresh in my mind. And at least one of them, Dr. York and the Typhoid Shot, is in this book. For me, it was just a return to a storyteller that I loved growing up, that had an impact on my life because of my inability to read and just turning towards the audio options of a day, and really storytelling really transitions well from a live presentation to a cassette tape. But also for me, just as a dyslexic reader, to conquer a book that I got before I knew how, before I could read, at a time where I probably should have been able to read, to have it this long and then finally read it felt really good. So I recommend it. I mean, if you go online, and you could probably go onto iTunes or whatever and find some Donald Davis storytelling, I recommend that. But also, like, this storytelling, and that's his grandmother. No, that's his great aunt. That's his great aunt on the cover. She's listening for the crack of dawn. I just highly recommend, like, you check out his work. The written work that he's done, this is being the one that I've read. There may be more. I just need to know. But this is from 1992, so I need to be updated on what's available. And the storytelling. And there may be other options, too, medium-wise, because he's just so good. He's just so good. And it's such a exciting time for me. Now, we're talking Appalachia. We're talking 50s and 60s and the South. North Carolina doesn't seem too south when you're in Tennessee, but now where I live, it does feel further south. I mean, it is further south geographically. When I moved to Tennessee, there was a lot of adjusting for me, weather-wise, culture-wise, language-wise. Donald Davis had this approach, had an accent, and really talked about kind of like that southern lifestyle. And it was cool for me. New kid, new school, new state, new part of the country that I'd never been to. To see that, I thought that mockingbirds were roadrunners, because it kind of looked like it. They run around, but they're mockingbirds, state bird of Tennessee. A lot of the stories were pretty foreign to me that Donald Davis was telling, but not only in time, but also in location. I'm just so happy I read this, listening for the crack of dawn. I think you would enjoy it. I did. 5 stars. But also, give Donald Davis a listen. He has really impacted my early life, and it was really nice for me to be able to return to some of that with this book. So, listening for the crack of dawn, Donald Davis, and other options that you can find his work in storytelling and writing. So, thanks. Have a good one.